Hey, welcome back to this channel, IndustryNx. As committed in the previous session, we are back with the part 3 of the video. Here, we will learn Z-score probability by using Z-score tables. This session is continuation of part 1 and part 2 videos. If you missed part 1 and 2, then we strongly recommend you to watch both earlier videos before starting part 3 to get better understanding. In last session, we learned that we can easily find out probability of plus minus 1, 2 and 3 sigma, but it is difficult to know value other than these values. Therefore, z-score and p-value tables are derived to find an area or say number of balls over an interval for any normal curve at any point. Before we solve this problem, we must get familiarized with z-score. A z-score is a numerical measurement used in statistics of a value's relationship to the mean, which is average of a group of values, which is measured in terms of standard deviation from the mean. Please note the shown formula to find z-score. Let us find z-score at mean, where x is equal to mu. Therefore, z-score value is always coming at 0 at center line of the bell-shaped curve. In our case, it is 10.000 minus 10.000 divided by sigma, which equals to 0. Let us find z-score where x is equals to 2 sigma, then z-score is equal to 2 sigma minus 0 sigma divided by sigma, which equals to 2. In short, 2 sigma z-score is 2 and 3 sigma's z-score is 3, and also minus 2 sigma's z-score is minus 2 and minus 3 sigma's z-score is minus 3. If a z-score is 0, it indicates that the data point score is identical to the mean score. You can see here z is equal to 0 at center and it is always positive value on right hand side of curve and increasing as shown. Similarly, it is always negative value on the left hand side of curve and decreasing as shown. In order to find probability, which is called as p-value, we need to measure area below curve. You can see p-value for complete curve is 1, that is 100%, which is shown in yellow block. This is again simple, but main challenge is that if we want to calculate p-value at point on the curve, probability is a number between 0 and 1, where 0 means impossibility and 1 indicates certainty. To find p-value for such cases, we need to refer two types of z-score tables. One is for z-positive score and one is for z-negative score. Both tables show the area to the left of given z-score, that is probability. Let us observe now how p-values is decreasing along with z-value decreases. Let me explain how to read z-score table to find p-value. Assume we want to find p-value for z-score of 2.82. Since z-score is positive, we need to refer positive value table. Now look for z-score in first column, up to tenths, that is 2.8, and hundredths place in top row, that is 0.2. Once you find these rows and column, then you need to find intersection values as shown, which is coming as 0.9976, that is 99.76%. This is nothing but p-values, that is probability for given z-score. Let us verify this table with our real example and find number of balls between mu to plus 0.5 sigma, that is from 10.000 to 10.003. First of all, we need to calculate z-score for 10.003. For that, we need to use below formula. Let us calculate z-score by using below formula. Hence, z score equals to 10.003 minus 10 divided by 0.006, which equals to 0.5. Let us find our p-value for z score, 0.50. Hence, total area to the left hand side is 0.6915. On left hand side means 691 balls. As we know that 50% balls are on the left hand side, that is 500 balls, you will find this also in z score table. If z equals to 0, then p value is 0.5, that is 50%. If we subtract 500 from 691, then we will get answer to our given problem, that is 191. Let us count physical balls to verify this logic of z score p value table. So we need to count total number of balls in all three compartments, which are 63 plus 62 plus 60, which equals to 185, which is very close to 191. This means there is some error in prediction. Therefore, we need to learn one more term, that is confidence interval, which you will learn in our next recommended NX session. To clear your concept, take a small assignment to find out number of balls on left hand side of 10.009, that is 1.5 sigma. Let us pause the video now and calculate answer yourselves and come back to check results. Welcome back. Check your answer by counting physical balls. We know this 500 balls. Hence, total balls will be 500 plus 63 plus 62 plus 60 plus 56 plus 52 plus 47 plus 42 plus 31 plus 24, which equals to 937, means 0.937 probability or 93.7%. If you are closer to this value, then it is perfect, or you need to do some practice, or you may contact us for detailed video on the same with multiple different types of examples for practice. These questions are being asked in job interviews. In next part, we will learn about process capability, CP and CPK. If you have not subscribed to this channel, do subscribe and press the bell icon for notifications. If you like this video, don't forget to share it with your friends and colleagues. See you in the next part.